For part two, we'll explore interpreting the standard deviation. So to understand the standard deviation, a quick note, you won't be asked to actually interpret the variance. It's a very difficult thing to interpret. All you really want to get out of it is that the larger the variance, the more spread out the data is. Because if you think about it, what we're squaring are the differences between a value and the average. So that number will be bigger if the spread is bigger. The standard deviation is going to have the same units as x. So in other words, if x is measured in dollars, so is s. If x is measured in feet, s is also measured in feet, etc. So that makes it a little bit more reasonable to interpret. But similarly, a data set with a larger standard deviation would also have a higher spread. We're going to do a little bit better than that, of course, but just to demonstrate this concept, looking at our version 1 distribution, the standard deviation was 1.4 for it, but the standard deviation for version 2 was only 0.9. So as we predicted, the spread should actually be smaller for that second distribution since the values were more consistent. Okay, so to explore interpreting these standard deviation and variance a little bit more, we have a theorem called CHEBYSHEV'S theorem or CHEBYSHEV'S rule. It allows us to interpret the standard deviation, and it applies to any shape distribution. So it's always going to be right. That doesn't mean it's always going to be useful, but it's always going to be right. So if the distribution is all crazy, it'll still work. So CHEBYSHEV'S rule goes like this. You just do 1 minus 1 over k squared times 100%, where k is the number of standard deviations you are away from the mean. So in other words, if k was 1, we'd have 1 minus 1 over 1 squared. Well, 1 over 1 squared is just 1, and 1 minus 1 is 0. So what we're saying is at least 0% of the data must fall within one standard deviation of the mean. Similarly, if we plug in 2, we'd have 1 minus 1 over 2 squared, so that's 1 minus 1 fourth, or 3 quarters, or 0.75. So that means 75% of the data would fall within two standard deviations. And you can keep going on, you can do 3, 4, 5, etc. But again, we're saying at least 75%, at least 0%, at least 88.9%. That's not necessarily very useful, especially when you look at the one standard deviation rule, at least 0% of the data falls within one standard deviation. That tells you nothing, absolutely nothing. So it's not really all that useful very often. So let's look at something called the empirical rule, which is more useful, but a little more limited. So the empirical rule only works for mound-shaped distributions, symmetrical and mound-shaped distributions. And we'll explore these a lot in chapter 4. But it's giving us another way to interpret the standard deviation. The rule goes like this. Unlike Chebyshev's rule, it's going to give you approximate percentages that fall within k standard deviations rather than minimums. So it actually gives you a reasonable approximation to work with as long as your distribution is mound-shaped and symmetrical. Again, only if it's mound-shaped and symmetrical. So here's the rule. If a distribution is mound-shaped and symmetrical, 68% or approximately 68% of that data will fall within one standard deviation. Approximately 95% will fall within two, and virtually all the data will fall within three standard deviations of the mean. 99.7%. That means only 3 out of 1,000 cases will not fall within 3 standard deviations. This is much more precise than Chebyshev's theorem, which only said at least 89% would fall within 3 standard deviations. Okay, so let's talk about interpreting the standard deviation. We have two different rules to work with, so when interpreting the standard deviation, we need to know which rule to use. So let's look at IQ scores to start off with. IQ scores are known to follow a mound-shaped and a symmetrical distribution. It's designed that way. That's the way the test is. So, and the average IQ is about 100, and the standard deviation is about 15 points. So, first question, what percent of people will have an IQ between 70 points and 130 points? And then the next question is, what percent of people will have an IQ over 115? So to address the first question, what percent of people will have IQs between 70 and 130, since we follow a mound-shaped and symmetrical distribution, we can use the empirical rule. And again, the empirical rule says 68% falls within one standard deviation. That means since it's symmetrical, 34% on each side. We know 95% fall within two standard deviations, so that means an extra 13.5% would fall on each side between one and two standard deviations. And then the remaining 5% will be split among the tails. So let's see, we're talking about between 70 and 90 points. Well, that's two standard deviations away on each side, so that means approximately 95% of IQ scores will fall between 70 and 130 points. Sorry about that. All right, going back to the second question, what percent of people will have IQs over 115 points? So looking at our graph again, 115 points is on the right over there, right over here. And we see 13.5% fall between one and two standard deviations, and an extra 2.5% fall to the right of two standard deviations from the mean. So adding those together, we should get 16%. So 16% of IQs fall over 115. So we now have a practical way of interpreting a standard deviation. If it's mound-shaped and symmetrical, we know that 68% of IQs will fall within one standard deviation, or in other words, 15 points of the average of 100. And we can answer all these kinds of questions with it. Let's look at example two. In example two, the average grade on a test is 70 points, and the standard deviation is 10. The question is, what percent of students scored between 50 and 90 points? So first we have to figure out what rule we should use, and then we have to figure out how many standard deviations away is 50 and 90 points. Well, we're not told anything about the distribution, so we're stuck with either assuming it's mound-shaped and symmetric, which isn't really a reasonable assumption, or we should just use CHEBYSHEV'S theorem, or CHEBYSHEV'S rule. So let's use CHEBYSHEV'S because we want to be correct here. So we have to figure out how many standard deviations away we are. So if K was 1, we would have 70 as the average, add and subtract one standard deviation, which is 10 on each side, and we get 60 to 80. Well, that's not right. So let's try two standard deviations. So if K is 2, going two standard deviations out, we would do 70 plus or minus 2 times 10. So 2 times 10 is 20. 70 plus or minus 20 gives you 50 to 90. That's what we want. So according to CHEBYSHEV'S theorem, at least 75% must fall within two standard deviations of mean, at least.